Hello friends, welcome to the series of SQLite database. So in previous video we have seen like insert operation in the same this application, so where we are getting the details has been added in the application. On now in this video we are going to see how to update the student data. So let me show you the demo first. So this is the first student detail. So whenever we click on any of the student, it will call the get student by ID function, and then as we can we are going to update the details of the student. So it will update the student details and it will route to the front page. So as you can see, Pramod has been changed with the updated details, and we are getting the message also. So let me put check the Ramesh, and Ramesh we can update it. So I'm going to update at Raghu and update it. So Ramesh has been changed to Raghu. So like this, this application is working now. So how to do this application? So on the first project setup video, we seen like we have created the two pages, students and student. So student, it's for the front page which we are able to see this one, and the second page is the student page for individual student. So this is the page. Whenever we click on the application on any of the student, this is the page, which is the individual page. Okay, so whenever we want to get the student, whenever I'm going to click on the any of the student, I'm getting routed to my first student individual student page. So we need to call the first function like get student details, like get student by ID function. So first let me check, let me go through with the routing.module.ts file where we have defined the students. So this is the routing path where we are passing the ID, and on click on this, like whenever this is the route, it will route me to the student individual student page. So this is the page, is this one, and so we'll go on the database service.ts file where we have defined the all database related functionality. So what we have done here, this is the function which will take the ID of the student, and it will return me the student interface, like it is the student we can say this is the bind of the student, and like same as the object, and it will return me the this much of data. So this is the SQL query, select star from the student where student ID is equal to this ID, and then data will we are going to return this much of the details to the student. So in the in return type we have defined the student, and student is the type of the interface which will have this property. Okay, so we are going to return this much of details. Now come to the student file, and let me show you the update functionality also. So update student functionality, this is the function name. So in that it will accept the student interface like a student object, and in that we are moving this data into the this data variable. So student.name, student.class, student.marks, and then after that we are calling the function return this dot execute database, execute SQL, in that update students, which is the table name, and set name equals to question mark, class is equal to question mark, common name marks is equal to question mark, and then where student ID is equal to student.studID. And then comma data will have the all the student related data, and then data will be we are calling the function this dot load student, which will load the updated student details. So then data, in that we are passing we are calling the function load student data, load student details. Okay, so this is the update student function, and this is the get student by ID function. So this is a simple SQL function only. Now come to the second part, which is the studentpage.es file where we need to define all the functionality. So here I have defined the student variable with the student type equals to null, and then as it will get in it, it will call, it will take the parameter like this dot route dot param map and dot subscribe in that params, and then whatever the param will be there, then we are saying that param.get of id, which is we are storing in the stud id variable. And while doing the constructor, we required a router, then we required route for take the this one, like whatever we are passing in the parameter, and then database service and toast controller for showing the message. And this router is for navigating my URL from the student. Okay, so whenever it will get initialized, it will call the function, and this it will call the this param map function, and in that we are taking the parameter, which is the ID, and then we are passing this ID to our database function stud ID, and after that we are setting our student variable with the data. So whatever data we are getting from this function, we are saving it in the student. And in update student data, what we are doing, we are calling this dot student, so this dot student only, and then this is all this thing for the toast controller to show the message. And as it will get success, we are navigating the route to the students. So this is the app routing model.ts file. So whenever it does get the student call, it will call the main page, which is the student page. So in the student page.ts, we have done this much. Get student by ID we are calling here, and update student data we are calling here. Update student data we are calling here. Okay. So now come to the student page.html file. So in that, this is menu button for this, that three drop down, that three bar, and then after that, this is the toolbar only. So and content classes and padding, and if ngf student have some data, then it will put data here only, student dot student name, student dot class, student dot mark, and user will change anything here. And then we are calling the on click, we are calling the update student data function, and then it will go to the this student page.ts file, and here it is calling the database function with the student updated details, and it is getting updated from database service.ts file. Okay, so I hope you got this much, like get student by id and update student data. So let me go through again with the application. So this is the application where the student data is getting updated, and so let me put change this one. So this will be add race, okay, just for taste only. And then I'm changing the class in the integer file and marks as 600. So as I will click the update student, it will call the function of update student, and it will update the data. So just update the student, and as you can see, it got updated, the last one as address 8, the last one address as 8, it got updated successfully. Okay, so I hope you got all this idea, and if you have any doubt, then please put in the comment section. I will definitely reply on that, and please subscribe to my channel, friends. Thank you.